Welcome to the Sheikah Serbu Motor Channel. This channel provides easy to understand explanations of car mechanisms. Atkinson cycle engines and Miller cycle engines are highly efficient four-stroke gasoline engines used in hybrid vehicles. The Otto cycle, Atkinson cycle, and Miller cycle, featured in this video, are thermodynamic classifications of four-stroke engines. Otto, Atkinson, and Miller are all names of individuals. Nicholas August Otto, a German, conceived the concept of the modern four-stroke gasoline engine in 1877. Therefore, the modern conventional four-stroke gasoline engines are classified as an Otto cycle. First, we will review the Otto cycle four-stroke gasoline engine. In the intake stroke, the intake valve opens, and as the piston moves downward, an air-fuel mixture is drawn into the cylinder. In the compression stroke, the piston moves upward, compressing the air-fuel mixture, which increases its pressure and temperature. The spark plug ignites the air-fuel mixture as the piston approaches the top dead center. In the combustion stroke, the air-fuel mixture burns rapidly and expands, pushing the piston downward. At this stroke, the engine generates power. In the exhaust stroke, the exhaust valve opens, and the piston moves upward to expel the burnt gases. The exhaust gas expelled during the exhaust stroke still contains energy. The heat of the exhaust gas warms the catalyst in the exhaust gas purification device, and in turbocharged engines, the pressure of the exhaust gas rotates the turbine wheel of the turbocharger. Finally, the pressure is reduced by the muffler's silencer before being released into the atmosphere. In other words, in Otto cycle engines, usable energy is being wasted. So, how can we make effective use of this wasted energy? We should let the combustion gases push the piston until all the energy is exhausted during the combustion stroke. Of course, such operation is not possible with a conventional crankshaft. Here, we will learn about the compression ratio and expansion ratio. Compression ratio refers to the value that indicates how much the intake air is compressed during the compression stroke. Expansion ratio refers to the value that indicates how much the burned gas expands during the combustion stroke. The compression ratio and expansion ratio are calculated by dividing the sum of the combustion chamber volume and the cylinder volume by the combustion chamber volume. In a typical Otto cycle engine, both the compression ratio and expansion ratio are around 10 to 11. To efficiently use up all the energy during the combustion stroke, we can simply increase the expansion ratio while keeping the compression ratio the same. In other words, this requires increasing the combustion stroke. The Atkinson cycle engine is an engine where the piston's movement varies between the intake, compression strokes, and the combustion, exhaust strokes. James Atkinson was a British engineer who developed this engine in 1887. However, the link mechanism was very complex, making high RPM operation difficult and unsuitable for automotive engines. Ralph Miller was an American who obtained a patent for the Miller cycle engine in 1957. The Miller cycle achieves different intake, compression strokes, and combustion, exhaust strokes without a complex link mechanism. In the Otto cycle engine, the intake valve closes when the piston is at the bottom dead center of the intake stroke. In practice, considering the inertia of the intake air, the valve closes slightly after the bottom dead center. When the valve is fully closed, the compression stroke begins. In the Miller cycle engine, the intake valve is not closed yet. As the piston rises, the intake air flows backward into the intake manifold. When the piston rises to a certain position, the intake valve closes and the compression stroke begins. In this way, the Miller cycle engine reduces the actual intake and compression strokes by closing the intake valve later. Since the combustion stroke is similar to that in Otto cycle engine, the Miller cycle engine achieve a higher expansion ratio than the compression ratio, leading to greater efficiency. However, There are also drawbacks. In a Miller cycle engine, the actual intake air volume is smaller, resulting in lower output compared to an Otto cycle engine with the same displacement. To overcome this, Ralph Miller installed a supercharger to enhance the output. An engine with a supercharger and a delayed intake valve closure. That's what a Miller cycle engine is. In 1993, Mazda adopted the Miller cycle for the KJZEM engine, which was supercharged by a LISM compressor and installed in the Unos 800. However, it was not commercially successful, and the engine disappeared from the market after several years. In 1997, Toyota adopted the Miller cycle 1NZ FXE engine for the Prius, the world's first hybrid vehicle. This is a bit of a complicated story. Toyota referred to this engine as the Atkinson cycle engine. As mentioned earlier, the Atkinson cycle is an engine that uses a complex linkage mechanism to achieve different compression and expansion ratios. So this engine is not an Atkinson cycle engine. Furthermore, since this engine is naturally aspirated, it is not a Miller cycle engine either. Strictly speaking, the 1NZ FXE engine is classified as a Miller cycle engine without a supercharger. Because it lacks a supercharger, its output is lower compared to an Otto cycle engine of the same displacement. We will compare the specifications of the Toyota Corolla's 1NZ FXE engine used in the hybrid model with the 1NZ FE engine used in the gasoline-powered model. Both engines have the same bore, stroke, and displacement. The 1NZ FXE for the hybrid model is a Miller cycle engine without a supercharger, with a maximum output of 54 kilowatts and a maximum torque of 111 newton meters. The 1NZ FE for the gasoline-powered model is an Otto cycle engine, with a maximum output of 80 kilowatts and a maximum torque of 138 newton meters. We can see that the 1NZ FXE engine has a lower output. Why did Toyota install the 1NZ FXE engine in the Corolla Hybrid without adding a supercharger, leaving it with lower output? Exactly. The hybrid motor assists the underpowered engine when needed, such as during acceleration or starting. Moreover, the electric power used by the hybrid motor is generated during deceleration or cruising, when the engine doesn't require much output. We can understand why hybrid vehicles have good fuel efficiency. Additionally, we can see another feature of the Miller cycle engine on this specification sheet. The compression ratio of the 1NZ FE engine is 10.5, which is typical for naturally aspirated engines in passenger cars. On the other hand, the compression ratio of the 1NZ FXE engine is 13.5, which is comparable to that of Ferrari's naturally aspirated engines. This value is simply calculated from the cylinder volume and the combustion chamber volume. As previously mentioned, the effective compression ratio of a Miller cycle engine is low. So, the effective compression ratio of the 1NZ FXE is likely around 10 to 11, similar to that of the 1NZ FE. Therefore, the effective compression ratio of the 1NZ FXE may be around 10 to 11, while the expansion ratio is 13.5. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. We'll see you in the next video.